Hello everyone, welcome to Cinematech, and we are reacting to the brand new Extraction 2 trailer. Let's check it out. Got a helicopter flying in. Assuming that this is just... yeah, these are scenes from the original film.
You're hoping if you spin the chamber enough times, you're gonna catch
Chris Hemsworth on the bridge, being a badass, getting shot. Yeah, this is all from the first film. Oh my god. If you drop your gun, you're definitely dead. That's what GoldenEye taught me. Say what you will about this film, the action sequences were pretty good. It was also surprising to me that they could do it for a budget of like $60 million, but I think that's largely because they shot it in India. They were able to just do it for much cheaper. Chris Hemsworth, no! Don't bleed out from the mouth, that's the other indication that you're dead. And he's in the river. So far, nothing new. We're about halfway through. Ooh, a fade to black. Is he...
You drown, not by falling into the river.
You don't drown by falling into the river. I mean, yes, that is how drowning works. And that inspirational talk is enough to bring Chris Hemsworth, Tyler Rake, back from the dead. Rake lives! Hashtag! So that's all we get. Thank you, internet, for hyping me up on a shot of Chris Hemsworth waking up underwater. what do we make of this? We don't get anything new. We don't see any new scenes from the film. That scene of him waking up might not even be in the new film. That could simply just be for this teaser alone. I guess it also could be the very first shot of the film, but that doesn't really do anything for us since the last shot of the first film has the kid in a pool and you can see kind of a figure watching over him. I think it's meant to be kind of a moment of suspense because you don't know if it's Tyler or if it's someone else who has actually found the kid and is going to do something not so great to him. But in this case, it appears that we're getting him waking up, and then perhaps as soon as he leaves this river after being shot multiple times and falling from a fairly substantial height, goes back to the kid, I guess, and meets him by the pool. So movie two probably starting right where movie one kind of finishes. I kind of hope that they don't tread on the same ground where it's just Chris Hemsworth protecting the kid, unless they just use that as a way of raising the stakes so much higher, the action stakes particularly, like maybe by keeping the plot that simple, they're able to just go for it really, really hard. Maybe that's what they're doing. I guess we'll have to wait and see. I was really hoping this was going to be a more substantial trailer, but it is not one of those things. So thank you, Netflix, but also, goddammit, Netflix. Why did you have to do this?